So the next property is multiplication in time domain. So here we are going to consider two signal x1 of t and x2 of t. Its Fourier series is coefficient is ak, its Fourier coefficient is bk. So multiplying two signal, that is x1 of t into x2 of t, which is equivalent to convolution of this represent convolution operation. So here convolution operation, so ak convolution bk. So this is what, that is a multiplication of the two signal in time domain is equivalent to convolution of the two signal, the same signal in frequency domain. So here what we need to do is the same procedure. Here we need to assign as y of t, here we need to assign ck. So first we need to have ck, so 1 by t integral 0 to t y of t e power minus jk om naught t dt. So this y of t, I'm substituting this x1 of t, x2 of t, because y of t is we have considered two signal. Now we know that x1 of t can be written as ak e power j k om naught t. So in order to differentiate this k from for this signal, I have used the symbol k1, which is nothing but a dummy variable. Both k and k1 are same. So k1 is equal to minus infinity to infinity ak1 e power j k om k1 om naught t. x2 of t e power minus jk om naught t into dt. Now what we need to do is I'm going to combine these exponentials, so you will get e power minus j k minus k1 into om naught t dt. Okay, now I'm going to combine the sum terms in order to get the equation. So 1 by t I am taking, this summation I have taken outside, this ak1 I have taken outside, integral x2 of t e power minus j k minus k1 om naught t dt. So I need to write the formula for this. So this is nothing but bk, because here for k I am having k minus 1. So we have already discussed what all the things we are having for k, there we need to put it. So k minus k1 we are having. So summation k equal to minus infinity infinity ak1 bk minus k1, so which is nothing but the convolutional formula, that is the convolution. Consider any discrete time signal. Here we are dealing with discrete in frequency, right? So y of n, which is equal to summation k equal to minus infinity to infinity, okay, a k b of k minus k1. So this is the formula for this. Okay, so here in this here you will have k1, so here you will have k1, so y of k is equal to summation k1 is equal to minus infinity to infinity a k b of k minus k1 is the, this is for a discrete case I am writing, x of k h of n minus k. Okay, so this is what the discrete case we are writing it. Okay, so we will see this in later. The don't bother about this. The simple thing is, so a signal will have as such, another signal is reversal and we have shift the signal. So this is the convolutional operation. So ck is equal to ak convolution bk. Now the next one is convolution in time domain. So first we have seen multiplication in time domain. Now we are going to see convolution in time domain. Okay, so here what I am going to do is I am going to consider two signal, that is I am going to perform convolution x1 of t convolution x2 of t. So the resultant what I need to prove is t into ak bk. So assign this as ck and assign this as y of t. Okay, now we need to prove ck equal to 1 by t, yes, right, integral 0 to t y of t e power minus jk om naught t into dt. So om naught t into dt. Now instead of this y of t, what we need to substitute is x1 of t convolution x2 of t. So this is what your y of t, and e power minus jk om naught t into dt. Okay, now the convolutional formula, x1 of t convolution x2 of t formula, this is the time domain formula. So here what we need to have is, so 0 to t x of tau, that is x1 of tau, x2 of t minus tau d tau. So in the previously we have discussed about for in discrete, so we will have summation there instead of integration. So here this is the convolutional formula for time domain. So now see, don't confuse with it, this is the discrete case. So I am getting summation remaining one signal as such, remaining signal is reversal and shifter. The same thing here, here the instead of summation I am having integration, one signal as such, then once another signal is reverser and shifted. The same concept here we are going to do. Now apply this formula here. So ck equal to 1 by t integral 0 to t, integral 0 to t, this for instead of this, so x1 of tau, x2 of t minus tau, e power minus j k ohm not t dt. Now I need to assume t minus tau is equal to lambda. So 1 by tau 0 to t, 0 to t, x1 of tau, here x2 of lambda, here for dt you should have d lambda. So before that I am going to substitute k ohm naught for instead of t, lambda plus tau into d lambda. Okay, here we are having it. So here I have forgot to write d tau, right? Because here if according to this formula, here you need to have d tau, right? This formula, x instead of this x1 of convolution x2 of t, here I am having d tau formula. So already you are having d tau here. Okay, so now expand this 1 by t 0 to t x1 of tau, and now remove the tau term here. So what you will get, you will get e power minus j k ohm not tau d tau, and you will have 0 to t, 0 to t x2 of lambda e power minus j k ohm not lambda into d lambda. Okay, so into d lambda here you will have it. Okay, so here what you will get is, this is 1 by t is nothing but your coefficient ak. So here you are not having 1 by t, so this can be written as t into bk. So this is what your ck, we got it. Okay, so thus the convolution of the two signal in time domain result in the multiplication of the two signal in frequency domain, and here the convolution of the two signal in frequency domain result in the okay, so this is what the thing you are going to understand in this convolution concept. Next property is differentiation in time domain. So first the same concept here we are going to write x of t Fourier series coefficient is ak. Now what we are going to do is, I am going to perform differentiation in time domain, that is d by dt x of t. So what you will get is here jk ohm not into ak I will get it, which is nothing but bk, and I am going to assign this as y of t. Okay, similarly here in general what we are going to write is y of t is equal to dn by dt n x of t, Fourier series is jk ohm not into n ak, which is equal to bk. So this is the property. So now we are going to prove only this, because after if we prove this, the same is applicable for this. Okay, now consider y of t. So y of t is equal to d by dt into x of t. Here we are going to differentiate for t, so there is no need to write down the bk formula. Just take this differentiation and supply the formula. So d by dt, so you know the formula for this. So summation k equal to minus infinity to infinity ak e power jk ohm not t. Okay, so what you are having is, you are having this equation. Now differentiate. So summation k equal to minus infinity to infinity ak. So you will differentiate only this e power jk ohm not t, right? So when you differentiate this, what you will get is k equal to minus infinity to infinity ak. So jk ohm not into e power jk ohm not t. So this is nothing but j k ohm naught. So summation k equal to minus infinity to infinity a k e power j k ohm naught t. Okay, so this is what the formula for, this is what the thing you will get it. Okay, so now this is nothing but your j, that is summation k equal to minus infinity to infinity. So you can write this as bk e power jk ohm naught t, where bk equal to ak into jk ohm naught. Okay, this is the thing I am going to get it. So this is what d by dt into x of t. Okay, so what we get, we got write this as, this is nothing but your y of t. Okay, so bk e power jk ohm naught t. So here, this is the for, when you take Fourier series, what you will get is this for BK, you will get AJK ohm naught t. Okay, instead of this Y of t, Fourier series is BK, right? Y of t. So for BK, what you are getting? So BK equal to AK JK ohm naught t. Therefore, this BK is equal to JK ohm naught into AK. So this is the proof we have got this. Okay, so I think we have got confused here. So why we have not written this formula here? Just we are going to find this Fourier value for this. So I have taken this as BK. Okay, understood? So here BK, AK, JK ohm naught t. So which is nothing but y of t, Fourier coefficient is bk. So this can be written as y of t, Fourier coefficient is bk, where bk is equal to jk ohm naught into ak. Okay. Next one is conjugation property. X of t conjugate, that is x of t Fourier series is ak. Now I am taking x of conjugate. So here what you will get is, here you will get x conjugate minus k. So this is nothing but your bk, this is nothing but your y of t. Now what I am going to do is, here I am going to take ak, where the formula is 1 by t integral 0 to t x of t e power minus jk ohm naught t into dt. Okay, now I am going to substitute, find the conjugate. A conjugate k is equal to 1 by t integral 0 to t. So x of t e power minus jk ohm naught t into dt, the whole power conjugate. Okay, so 1 by t integral 0 to t x conjugate of t. So this will become plus, now when you take conjugate, plus t dt. Okay, so which is nothing but this can be written as this, when you simplify this, if you want to write down in this AK formula, so you need to have minus, because here you are not having minus. What we need to do is, in the next step, 0 to t x conjugate of t e power minus j minus k ohm naught t multiplying by 2 minus, so which is nothing but this is what you were already A conjugate k. So here I am having minus k, so this can be written as a conjugate minus k. Okay, so what we have proved is this a conjugate minus k, we have proved this by performing conjugation on x conjugate of t. The next one is Parseval relation. What we are going to actually study and understand from this Parseval relation is, that is the total energy power in a periodic signal. So this relate the power, right? Total energy, total average power in a periodic signal is equal to sum of all the average power in all of its harmonic component. Okay, so that is what's the Parseval relation. What I am repeating, the Parseval relation states that the total average power in a periodic signal equal to sum of the average power in all of its harmonic component. Okay, so here I have taken this one. So with, now I am going to prove it. So considered 1 by t integral 0 to t, this x of t the whole square dt I am writing, taking. So this can be written as integral 0 to t x of t x conjugate of t dt, I can write it. So here 1 by t integral 0 to t x of t. So for this formula I can write this as summation my k equal to minus infinity infinity ak a conjugate of k e power minus jk ohm naught t into dt. We know that x of t formula is summation k equal to minus infinity to infinity a k e power j k om naught t. Okay, now I am taking conjugate, so I am getting a conjugate k and e power minus j k om naught. That what I have written here. Okay, and now what we need to do is, so take this summation outside. So summation k equal to minus infinity a k conjugate, combine remaining terms, 1 by t integral 0 to t x of t e power minus jk om naught t dt. So what is this equivalent? This equivalent is nothing but your ak, so which is nothing but summation k equal to minus infinity infinity magnitude of ak the whole square. So here we are going to see the last property, that is conjugate symmetry for real signal. That is, if x of t is a real value signal, if your input is a real value, x of t real value means, for example, consider here I am having a square waveform, right? This can be represented as x of t is equal to a like that, right? Real value, right? So x of t is equal to, when you take a conjugate for this, you will get both are same. The conjugate and the x of t is same. And similarly here, ak and a conjugate minus k are same if the x of t is real. Next case, if x of t is even, so what will happen is, for even signal x of t is equal to x of minus t, right? Similarly ak equal to a minus k. So this reversal is also both are equal. Okay, so then the third one is, if x of t is real and even, both cases I'm going to apply both cases. So what will happen is, ak is real and even for all k. Okay, if x of t is real and even, ak is real and even for all case. Okay, so next one is, if x of t is odd, that is if x of t is odd, so if it is x of t is odd, we know that x of t is equal to minus x of minus t and ak is equal to minus a minus k. So this is what the thing we are going to understand from this. Now the next one is, if x of t is real and odd, both conditions, so real and odd, so what will happen if it is real and odd? Ak is purely imaginary and odd. Ak is purely imaginary and odd. Okay, then if x of t is real, that is if x of t is real, then magnitude value is equal to both are same and angle of both values are same. Okay, so this is what angle of both value, that is not same. Here you will have minus of a minus k. So this is what the thing you are going to understand from the conjugate symmetry. Hope you have understand all the properties. In the next video, we will discuss about how to solve problem using these properties. Thank you.